What's going on, guys? Today I am half Handsome Homebuyer, half Captain Permit, and we're talking about the permit process. All right, so the building permit process. We're gonna give you a high-level overview about what goes on Long Island, New York, but specifically Long Island. So just so people understand, when I first got into this business, I was so confused. I was getting in trouble. I was getting stop work orders all the time. I was like, what do I need a permit for? What do I not need a permit for? Called up the building department and said, hey, what do I need a permit for? And the nice lady that answered the phone is like, well, that would take forever and it'd be a book that's probably a foot high. I was like, how about this? What don't I need a permit for? And she said, oh, that's much simpler. You don't need a permit to change a window that's the existing size, go over an existing roof, and maybe paint. I'm like, that's it? She's like, that's it. So I'm like, anything and everything. Change kitchen counter, change a toilet bowl, change a sink, rip a roof off. I need a permit for that? She says, you need permits for everything. So just wanted to clarify that up front. You essentially need permits for everything. I myself, as a building developer, hate the permit process. I think everybody does. It takes a lot of time, it becomes very expensive. It takes a lot of time, which becomes very expensive. It's very aggravating. It is necessary because unfortunately everybody out there is not doing the right thing and renovating houses properly, not because they necessarily don't want to, because they don't have the in-depth knowledge of building code. So I get it. But if you need permit help, obviously there's one person to go, one person who's got you all the time. That's the captain, Captain Permit, 516-513-8838. But let's talk about the permit process here for a second. Boop. We interrupt your permit process video to ask you to please, 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 if you haven't, like, subscribe, click that bell. Thank you for support. Back to permits. At a high level, there's two types of permits. There's a maintained permit and there's a proposed permit. What is the difference? Let me explain. A maintained permit is what we service a lot of our real estate agent clients on and current homeowners. Let's say John Smith homeowner purchased a house 30 years ago, either with a deck on the back or his father or him 20, 30 years ago built a deck out there without a permit. Nobody knew, nobody cared. It didn't matter 30 years ago, right? Now they go to sell the house, title report comes back, attorney calls up and says, hey, there's no permit for the deck. What do? You have to file a maintained permit. So a maintained permit is essentially legalizing something that already existed, okay? The other type of permit there is a proposed permit. A proposed permit is when you are going to build something, you're gonna do interior alterations. If you're an investor and you're gonna gut renovate a house or do any kind of work to a house, you're gonna file a proposed interior alteration permit. Now, the difference between the maintained and the proposed is, the maintained, there's an inspection only one time at the end, but they double or triple the permit fee. On a proposed, there's multiple inspections, which we're gonna go over during the process, and they charge you a much, much lower permit fee. The way they calculate the permit fees is the township has a grid, essentially, where they assign a dollar amount to a specific renovation, and then they charge you a percentage of that dollar amount, and that's essentially how it works. They decide, it doesn't matter what we want to say, we could say it's gonna cost $3,000 to do this renovation, they're gonna turn around and say it costs $40,000, they ultimately win, they have the power. But that's really essentially the main difference between a maintained permit and a proposed permit. Now again, interior alterations, if you're a fix and flip investor or if you're a buy and hold investor and you're gonna be doing renovations to a house, primarily what you're doing is interior alterations. And that ranges anywhere from, you know, framing, windows, kitchen, paint, moldings, wood floors, etc. It's kind of all encompassing. And when we do the plans and we put them in, we're essentially gonna call out and define exactly what it is that you're doing so the building department knows. So that it's clear, the building department wants to have plans and permits and COs on file for anything and everything that was always done to the house. So at any given time, the building department can look in their files and what they have on record as far as plans and permits and COs goes is what is reflected and actually in your house. Now understand, when you file any type of, let's say, maintained or proposed permit, the town is gonna come through and walk through your entire house. So anything at that point that is not legal is going to need to be legalized. So just know that up front. This way when Captain Permit or whoever does your architecture and expediting work knows, it's just better to draw everything and file it at once so that you don't waste time, okay? Let's talk about parts of the permit process. surveys. A lot of townships require that you have a survey, a new survey, a survey that's 6 months old or newer. Why is that? Because they want to make sure and they want to see that maybe there's something else on your property that they don't know about that they can then charge you for and make you legalize. It's that simple, okay? So you're at a lot of places, you're going to need a survey. And this is why in the permit process, you want to be very, very, very proactive. You want to start the moment you get something under contract, if you're an investor, or the moment, or even before you list the property, if you're gonna sell it as a homeowner, or if you're a realtor who's going to take on a listing, the moment you take on the listing, you wanna know all these things because they take time, and time can be a problem. A lot of townships, like I said, require that survey. A survey can take a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, depending on who your surveyor is. All right, you're always going to need plans, regardless of if it's a maintainer or proposed. You're going to need architectural plans in most places of typically the entire house. Now, a lot of times people will say to us, hey, it's just a bathroom, it's just a basement. Yes, back in the day, we used to be able to draw just the bathroom, just the basement and section. Now with the townships wanting to see exactly what is in the house, and then obviously the more things that need to be legalized, the more money they make, they typically want plans of the entire house, unless you're doing a deck or a shed or something on the exterior. All right, so you'll need full architectural plans. You're gonna need a plumber to file a plumbing permit in both of these scenarios, depending on what you're legalizing. On the maintain side, if you had a deck, obviously you don't need a plumber if you have a deck. But if you have any kind of room or anything that involves water, gas, any type of plumbing in a space that you're gonna be legalizing, need the plumber to file a plumbing permit. All right, so you would put in the building plans, you would put in a building permit first, the plumber would come in and then file a plumbing permit. Now, the building permit has to be approved first before the plumber can then go attach the plumbing permit. There are certain times where the towns will just request a plumbing permit for certain things, but typically they want plans with a building permit, then the plumber files and attaches his plumbing permit to the building permit. Okay? Same thing with proposed. With proposed, you're gonna file to do interior alterations or put a dormer on or whatever it is. Once the permit is issued, the plumber is then gonna go file his or her permit and attach to that permit and pay the fees respectively. Electricians, same thing. Now, electrical is a little bit different. The townships have building inspectors that do building inspections and do plumbing inspections. No township on Long Island that I'm aware of, except the Village of Hempstead, does its own electrical inspections. So what's gonna happen is your electrician is gonna file, but they're gonna work with an underwriting company or a fire and get a fire underwriters or UL certificate. That's an independent company that comes in that inspects during the process or after and gives you papers, sign-offs during the process that you then turn in to the building department. So just so we understand here, in a maintained situation, the plumber will come in and file one and do one inspection at the end. The electrician will file and do one inspection at the end. With the proposed, you'll have multiple inspections during the process of both, and I'll explain that when we get to the inspection section, but they're applicable in both situations, okay? You also are gonna need a contractor. Now, in the maintain scenario, you do not need a contractor. In the proposed scenario, you do need a contractor. And that contractor makes sure, I can't stress how important this is. I know costs are going up, I know things are expensive, I know it's very difficult, I know we're trying to make money, I know houses are scarce for a lot of people. Do not, I implore you. I've seen way too much crazy shit go on in the last 5.5 years. Do not hire somebody that is not licensed and not insured. Figure the money, make the right offers, make less money, whatever the hell you have to do, but do not hire somebody that doesn't have a license and does not have insurance, and check with your insurance provider to make sure that the insurance is adequate and that you're protected in the right way, because that could be a major, major problem, okay? Let's count down to the inspections. To recap what we were doing before, again, maintain inspections are a lot easier. Yes, you pay double or triple the fees, but the inspections are far less. You're gonna have one inspection done at the end. It's gonna be whatever needs to be seen. A lot of times they'll ask the architect to provide a letter stating that everything that's on the plans that the building department can't see behind the walls is done to code and as per the drawings, but they're only gonna do one inspection for each. So they'll do one electrical inspection, one plumbing inspection, one building inspection, you're done. Proposed is a lot more involved. So let's run through the gamut. Let's say you're building a house from scratch. You're gonna have multiple foundation inspections. You're gonna have two foundation inspections. You're gonna have a framing inspection. You're gonna have a rough electrical. You're gonna have a rough plumbing. You're gonna have an insulation inspection. you're gonna have a final plumbing, a final electric, and a final building. You're gonna have 9 inspections. Now, if you're doing the interior alterations and you're gut renovating a house, the only thing you're cutting out is the foundation inspections. You're gonna have 7 inspections. It's a pain in the ass. I don't know other way to say it. You have to make sure you're efficient. You have to make sure you're scheduling properly. It is going to take time, and the time is gonna drag on a little, and it is gonna cost you money. So know what you're getting into so that you can be scheduling these guys early enough so you get them in as quick as possible. And once you start working in certain townships, you build relationships with inspectors, they know you're doing the right job, they become a little bit cooler and understanding about things, but it's very, very, very important. Now, this comes down to time. Time, 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 it becomes a process. So when you deal with Captain Permit, our goal is to call us and to be out to the job within a week or less, and then have the plans in between 1 to 3 weeks, depending on if there's design involved, how many rounds we have to go back and forth with, how proactive you are with getting us the information and the feedback, okay? Once the plans go into the building department, it really, really depends. There's some places where plans get approved in a day. There's some places like the town of North Hempstead where plans get approved in 6 months. Now, when plans go into the building department, 99% of the time, they're going to come back with objections, okay? That's just how it is. It doesn't matter if God himself put the plans in. There's most building departments will always object to something or have some kind of question. And remember, there's so many different plans examiners that depending on who gets it, they're gonna have different questions and different feedback. So typically the plans go in, they sit on somebody's desk for a certain period of time, they get looked at, their objections, they're sent back to us as the architect, we have to, as the expediter, have those addressed, changed, stamped, and resubmitted, and typically on the second go around, they go through. This is just part of the process. You wanna be proactive. What I do with all my fix and flip deals is I file before I even own the property. You can get the current owner's permission to file, or in certain townships, they don't even care. You could file a permit on anybody's house even if you don't know them, right? File right away. I try to file like a month before. This way, hopefully, by the time I close on the property, I have a permit and my guys are ready to go. It pays to be proactive. It pays to know what you're doing. It pays to get started early. Okay, now let's get down to the cost. The cost really ranges widely depending on what you're doing. If you're maintaining a deck, it could be as low as $1,500 plus your permit fees, you're looking at a few thousand dollars. If you're doing new construction homes, I've seen people quote new construction homes in the tens of thousands or everything between, depending on how involved and how big it is. You know, for your basic, let's say, maintain basement, you're looking at a plumber. The plumber is gonna charge you anywhere from $750 to $1,250 just for his signature. You're looking at the maintain fees for the town. I'm sure they're anywhere from $750 to $2,000. You're looking for the electrical underwriter certificate is anywhere from $200 to $500. You do the math, it adds up. If you're doing proposed interior alterations on a property, you're looking at proposed drawings of the entire house, anywhere in the neighborhood of between $3,000 and $6,000. Then you're looking for your plumber and your electrician already being paid to do the job, so they shouldn't charge you any additional fees, but you have plumbing permits fees, that could be $1,000 to $1,500. You have electrical certificates, that could be $1,000 to $1,500. You have building department fees, which can range anywhere from $1,000 to $10,000+, depending on the extent of the work that you're doing. So for me, if you're gonna be doing a gut renovation, you have to budget between $5,000 and $10,000 as an investor if you're operating on Long Island, every project just to handle the plans, the surveys, the permit fees, the plumber, electrician, etc. So it's unfortunate, but it's part of the process. I'm just happy that now you guys have a general understanding about what's involved. And obviously, if you have any questions, you can DM me or you can reach out to Mike, the Jacked Captain, at 516-513-8838. If you've made it this far, we really appreciate you. I hope you learned something. And obviously, I would just appreciate that like, that subscribe, and ring that bell. Until next time, I'm the Handsome Homebuyer and Captain Permit.